tell my children who are black, or what it means to be a captive in this dark skin? How shall I tell my dear ones, fruit of my womb, of how beautiful they are, when everywhere they turn, they are faced with abhorrence of everything that is black? The night is black and so is the boogeyman. Villains are black with black hearts. A black cow gives no milk. A black hen lays no eggs. Bad news comes bordered in black. Morning clothes are black. Storm clouds are black. Black is evil and evil is black. And devil's food is black. All that is bad is black. What should I tell my dear ones who have been raised in a white world? A place where white has been made to represent all that is good and pure and fine and decent. Where clouds are white and dolls and heaven, heaven surely is a white, white place filled with angels robed in white and cotton candy and ice cream and milk and ruffled Sunday dresses and dream houses and long, sleek Cadillacs. And angels' food is white, all white. What can I say, therefore, when my black child comes home to me in tears because a playmate identical to himself has called him black, big-lipped, flat-nosed, and nappy-headed? What will he think when I dry his tears and whisper, yes, that's true, but you are no less beautiful and dear? How shall I lift up his head, get him to square his shoulders, to look his adversaries in the eye, confident in the knowledge of his worth, serene under his sable skin and proud of his own beauty? What can I do to give him the strength that he may come through life's adversities as a whole human being, unwarped and human, in a world full of biased laws and inhuman practices, that he might survive, and survive he must. For who knows, perhaps this black child of mine here bears genius to discover the cure for cancer, or the brilliance to chart the course for the exploration of the universe. So he must survive, for the good of all humanity, he must and will survive. I have drunk deeply of late from the fountain of my black culture. I have sat at the knee of and learned from Mother Africa. I have discovered the truth of my heritage, the truth so often obscured and omitted, and I find I have much to say to all of my black children. I will lift up their heads in proud blackness and tell them the story of their fathers and their fathers' fathers. And I shall take them to a way back time of kings and queens who ruled the Nile, who raised the pyramids, who measured the stars, who discovered the laws of music and mathematics and more. And I will tell them of a black people upon whose backs have been built the wealth of three continents, Europe, Africa, and America. And I will tell them this and more. And knowledge of his heritage shall be his weapon and his armor. It will make him strong enough to win any battle he may face. And since this story is so often obscured, I must sacrifice to find it for my children, even as I sacrifice to feed, clothe, and shelter them. This I'll do for them if I love them. Nobody else will do it for me. I must find the truth of heritage for myself and pass it on to them. And in years to come, I believe, because I have armed them with the truth, my children and their children's children will venerate me, for it is the truth that will make us free. I wanted to present to you one of my prints, and this is called The Extended Family. Extended Family. And it's the reproduction of a linoleum block print that I made. Mm-hmm. So this is for you, Ms. Deborah Ham.
Dr. Burroughs, thank you so much. You are truly my extended family, and I'm so honored to have you participate in my art career, and I appreciate that so much.
You got it.